trashed by the media, trashed by almost everybody. You know, you were public enemy number one in politics for that period. You've been followed by others. The cycle moves on. Others fall down. They get kicked too. What was the experience like for you on a human level? Because you're not the caricature that we all read about. You're the guy, and I think you were honest enough to say in an interview that, you know, you used to pick up papers and say, you idiot, other people who've done what you've done. And suddenly you're that guy. How does it feel?
It's humbling. Off the set, we were just speaking a moment ago, and I said to you very candidly that I've done thousands of interviews back through Congress and through the governorship, and I was never one moment afraid. It was, we could agree or disagree on an issue, but we were where we were. And now as you step back out, because I think I need to do my best, as best I can, in warning the country on what I think is coming our way if we don't change the direction, you still walk out scared. And I've never been scared before, but I'm a little bit frightened inside. And I think it is because, you go through that two-year process, which was rather glaring, and you don't want to disappoint anybody. You know that you let a lot of people down, and there's a whole lot of anxiety that comes with an interview there for thinking on how you might let somebody down, and you don't want to do that.
Looking back on it, I mean, you're still with the woman that you left your wife for. She's an Argentinian, Maria Belen Chapur, proving, I guess, that this wasn't just a short-term fling. You didn't throw everything away for nothing. That there's a love story there. Given that, do you feel great regret, or is that the wrong emotion to put to you?
Well, I think that anybody who's been married doesn't start at the beginning thinking, boy, I hope I someday get divorced. I hope that someday the train comes off the track. So there's got to be regret. There's something sacred about a family unit, about boys. I have four boys. You have some boys. And anything that brings harm to your boys, you have genuine regret about. I think that, you know, part of the journey for me over the last couple of years has been, you know, first professionally, you know, in the wake of the whole storm, you know, this question, do you just quit and walk out of there and never see another camera again, which would have been by far the easiest thing to
which
do.
Which you didn't do. Yeah, you stuck it out. Yeah.
And so professionally, you said, can we somehow make some good of this? Because what people were telling me at the ground level was, Mark, you messed up, you disappointed us, but you finished strong. And so we tried as best we could, and we had actually the most productive legislative year that we had in all 8 years during that last year. In a personal sense, you hope that you learn from it in terms of...
What have you learned about yourself?
Well, I think I've learned a lot. As you were just joking a moment ago, I never publicly judged, but privately I judged. I think we're all prone to do so. And you read the paper, and indeed you'd say loser, loser, idiot, moron.
I mean, you voted for the impeachment of Bill Clinton, Monica Lewinsky, for example.
And so I think now you look at things and you sort of say, but by the grace of God, go I. I'm going to worry about the log in my own eye before I worry about the splinter in somebody else's. I've learned a lot about grace. There is just, again...